today on the TMZ Podcast.
Hello and welcome to the TMZ Podcast. I'm Charlie Cotton and joining me today is newsbreaker, baby maker.
Breaking news.
Deven Rall.
Changed it up there. I appreciate that.
Congrats, you having a baby?
Thank you so much. It's a little girl. It's coming September.
It's very sweet.
This is the news everyone was here to listen to.
Yeah, that's our breaking news.
This is what they were for.
All right, guys. See you tomorrow. Yeah. No. Our girls are going to be born like a week apart, apparently.
If the due we're still talking about this. Let's
move. Okay, okay. What do we got today? Christine Quinn, reality star from Selling Sunset. Her husband was just arrested for assault with a deadly weapon. Really nasty stuff. Their kids involved. This has just gotten really ugly. We'll talk about Shohei Otani.
Yeah, crazy story.
The guy who signed a $700 million contract with the Dodgers. Well, his interpreter was just fired because he stole money from Shohei.
That's what Shohei's saying.
What?
Well, the interpreter was saying he lended him the money.
Oh, wow. Yeah, yeah. Okay. I didn't realize that.
Yeah.
Our Almost News is pretty good. Just a little segment about drinking blood. But to begin with, Kate Gate, it rages on. Piers Morgan, he's known for his mild-mannered comments.
Does he, I know you're like well-versed in this. What is his relationship with the Royals? Not good, right? Doesn't he kind of hate them or hate on them or do you not know?
He's just like a shock jock.
Okay.
He's over there. He's got a TV show. He's a reporter.
Yeah, yeah,
but he says inflammatory, salacious sort of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he's saying as part of our TMZ new documentary, it's called TMZ Investigates, Where is Kate Middleton? He's saying that
it's premiering tonight.
It's premiering tonight on Hulu.
Harvey's very fired up.
I know, man. I was fired up about Kate until Harvey got fired up about Kate. And now it feels oversaturated.
Well, who knows? Maybe we'll find out where she is.
Yeah, that
will tune in.
Yeah, tune in. We got the answers. But Piers Morgan is now saying he doesn't buy the Kate Middleton photo timeline. How about we hear him in his own words?
I'm not convinced that the picture of Kate herself was taken the week before, because I know somebody who saw her that week who said she didn't look anything like the picture.
What did this person say she looked like?
It was just somebody who bumped into her, who knows her, who just said that she looked a lot thinner than she did in the picture. But certainly if you look at the picture, she looks absolutely blooming with good health. I do not believe that's an accurate reflection.
I love the dramatic music.
I know. Where is she? But also, I don't know when that... Did we interview this guy a couple days ago, maybe?
Yeah, this week.
Because...
I believe it might have been before we got the video.
Yeah, when the video came out, she did look way skinnier, to be honest. Like I think
but no,
right.
But I was going to say, our video actually completely backs up Pierce. But,
yes.
But at the same time, also... There's been all the photoshopping claims, no, about this photo.
Yeah, so but it's not even her, basically, you know?
Well, no, so...
It's an old photo, at least.
That's what I'm saying. So hasn't people been claiming that already, or no? People were saying that she sat down with her kids, and then they just photoshopped different pieces of her, right?
Yes,
but
yes.
now Pierce is saying that face isn't even... was from whenever.
Well, I mean, if TikTokers are to be believed... They like matched up all of this stuff. They think this photo's from November. You know what I mean? But I mean,
and what's their evidence?
Because the kids were wearing similar outfits,
okay.
And they match a bracelet. You know what I mean? They
did
the online sleuthing.
They did all the good work.
They did all the good work for us. But she did look really skinny in that farm, like when they're at the farm shop or whatever we're calling
it.
Yeah. And so this photo. Supposedly taken a week or two earlier.
Doesn't make any sense at all.
Either
she doesn't. She doesn't look the same at all.
No, she doesn't.
And to be honest, like if the video we got really backs up what Pierce is saying,
it does.
Because what he's describing, what he say his friends saw,
yeah,
is exactly what we saw.
Totally
in that video.
Other things that Harvey's really fired up about this documentary. He's saying, why is there no ring on this photo?
I heard him say that a bunch this morning.
I know. He's got lots of interviews this morning about the documentary. He's like, why is there... And it's true. Why is there no ring on her hand.
Well, because, right, because they were saying they probably, I think I saw something that they photoshopped and they might have used her other hand and then flipped it.
Right.
And so obviously you wouldn't have a ring on that hand, but if you're a good photoshopper, wouldn't you then just photoshop a ring on?
Yeah. I mean,
it's like,
unless
the person? Okay, I know we want to find where Kate is and what happened. I also want to find the Photoshop guy.
Well, funny you should mention that, because the Royals have just advertised a new job position that they're looking.
Is this serious?
Yes, a communications assistant. And it's got to do with this sort of stuff. It's got to do with like dealing.
Well,
with...
yeah, because after what's happened, they have to clean house, dude.
Yes,
and everyone's gone.
And so the first person to go is their communication assistant, you know, and now they're hiring for $30,000 a year.
Wow,
They should up how much they want to pay.
Yeah,
someone
that's to it. Like, you need to pay like someone that actually like is expecting
good at Photoshop.
Good at Photoshop and is expecting a good salary.
Right.
So what happens when they like kick out the old Photoshop guy?
I mean,
there's like those guys that stand in front of the castle that like don't talk. Like they walk up and they just get denied.
I think they put their guns or they don't have guns. Their swords or something in front of.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
nope, no passing here. Another thing is, Harvey says that, you know, we're pretty sure and there was an ambulance that went to her house just after Christmas, and that Kate might have been in the back on the way to the hospital afterwards. So a planned abdominal surgery doesn't track with an ambulance going to your house just after Christmas.
Yeah, because then your husband or whatever would take you.
Right.
Take you to the hospital.
It doesn't make any... Why would you need an ambulance for a planned thing?
It might have been some type of emergency thing, but again... I get it. Like a lot of people are very sensitive about putting their, you know, health stuff out there, which is fine. But it's just so weird that like this all has happened and they wouldn't just at this point, like, let's just come forward with it. Let's do a press conference.
Yeah. I mean, the truth can't be stranger than the conspiracy theories, can it?
I don't know. We'll have to find
out.
Where
tell
is
us
Kate?
The truth.
Where is Kate?
It'll all be answered
tonight at 9 on Fox and Hulu, right?
Hulu the next day, Deven.
Oh, so yes, tomorrow.
You can restream it. Can't wait.
Tune in.
Okay, on to our next story. Christine Quinn, her husband, Christian, was arrested for assault with a deadly weapon. Allegedly, they were in a fight, the two of them, and he threw a bag of glass at her. It missed her, and it hit their 2-year-old son, also by the name of Christian.
That's a bad miss. And that's a lot of like Christians, Christines.
Yeah.
That would get very confusing in that household. Not to make light of a very serious situation.
Right. So an ambulance had to come. They treated the kid at the scene. He might have actually been transferred to the hospital.
He was transferred to the hospital. That was a little unclear at first, but he was. Christine went with the kid. And I have an update for you. A breaking news update. I don't know if you do that on this show.
We do now. Let's hear it.
Christian's been arrested again.
What?
Yeah, he went back to the house last night, and I believe we're putting this story up right now, but he was arrested again because she had an emergency protective order for him not to come back, and he came back.
God.
So there's a lot going on here. I mean, this is the classic situation. Obviously, I don't know what happened inside the house, just what cops are saying happened. Very messy, obviously. But, I mean... This is one of the situations where this super rich guy, you know how kind of like the arm candy,
trophy wife,
and it's clearly something went terribly wrong.
Because these two were both on Selling Sunset. I mean, obviously Christine a whole lot more, but when she met this Christian guy, he was
isn't he like a billionaire? He's super rich, no?
It's unclear how rich he is because he got most of it from crypto.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
so a guy after your own heart.
Yeah, well, I mean, I love crypto, but he got in much earlier than I did.
Yeah,
I got
clearly.
In. I got in right before it
clearly,
bust.
Clearly, because he's living in the hills and you're here right now at 6 a.m.
I know. But so he's like super rich. They live in whose old house? Crystal Hefner's old house?
Oh, okay. I believe Crystal and Christine are friends.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But he was always kind of mysterious, really rich, and she was like, just so, I've got the life. She was like so braggadocious about like, now I'm rich as well. And she had it made, but there was obviously a lot going on behind the scenes that she wasn't comfortable talking about.
Totally. And do you see the, talk about bad visual, man.
What?
Him getting arrested in the robe.
It's like a Netflix.
It's a bad visual, dude.
But the visual looks like it's out of a Netflix like drama
Like kind of the bald head, the glasses askew.
Yes, his bathrobe.
His bathrobe.
And his
Do people actually wear robes still?
Only at hotels, I thought. Yeah, at your own home.
Yeah, interesting.
I actually use, this is actually a life hack. At home, instead of using a towel, I use a poncho towel. That is the best way to get dry. With like a towel on your head, you stay... Anyway.
This is the most Australian take of all time. Have you guys ever heard of this?
A poncho towel. It's great.
Poncho towel?
Yeah, if you don't want to be cold out after the shower.
Are you sponsored by them or something?
I wish. You can sponsor this podcast if you'd like.
Interesting. A poncho
towel.
A poncho towel. Or you could just dry off with a towel like a normal human being.
Too cold. Too boring.
Okay. All right.
So, wow, that's crazy breaking news.
Yeah, so he's been arrested twice in the last couple of days. I guess we'll see what ends up happening.
God. Terrible. Okay. Yeah. On to our next story. Baseball's it guy, Shohei Otani, his interpreter that has been with him for at least 6 years while he's been with the Angels, has now been fired because he illegally bet. He did sports betting with a legal bookmaker. His name is Matthew Boa. And basically, in California, you can't really...
No, it's illegal to gamble on sports and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the only way to gamble when you're in California is technically illegally. Like, offshore, you have, like, bookies like this guy had.
And so this bookie was kind of like, there was a big investigation about him. And they saw that funds were coming from Shohei Ohtani's account. So it was like, is Shohei Ohtani illegally betting?
Which would be a huge issue.
Oh.
Apparently, there's reports coming out this morning that saying he's not being investigated for being involved with the betting, but that's just what's like coming out now. But this story's insane because apparently yesterday, the interpreter who has been like his boy, because ever since he moved here in like 2018, they've been friends and he's his interpreter. And it's like, obviously, he doesn't speak very good English, so I'm assuming that's one of the only people he really talks to. I'm sure he has other friends that he speaks Japanese
right.
to and stuff.
You get paid to be his friend, basically.
No, exactly, but they've clearly close. He did a whole sit-down with ESPN where the interpreter was essentially saying, Shohei wasn't involved. I had this huge debt. I think it was like $4 million or something.
$4.5 million.
That then Shohei helped me pay off. So he like was like helping me out. And then right before ESPN's about to do the interview, it gets canned and Shohei Ohtani's people come in and are like, no, this is not true. And basically this guy stole money from Shohei. So it's like, it's a crazy story. So it's like, what happened here?
That is crazy. Do you think that, you know, hypothetically this guy's like a fall guy?
I mean, he could be a fall guy, but at the same time, if he was a fall guy, then why would Shohei's attorneys come out and release an on-the-record statement saying this guy stole from him?
Right. That could be
You know what I mean?
Yeah, they're throwing him under the bus.
Yeah, and it's like, if I was the fall guy, it's like, wait a second here. Unless that's like he's being a really good fall guy.
Right.
And they're doubling down. So I don't know. Regardless, I mean, obviously whatever's going on is going to come out. He just made $700 million for the Dodgers.
This guy blew it. Like, well, you should have hung on for a little bit longer.
Oh, you're saying the
betting guy. Yeah,
the interpreter totally. He fumbled the bat.
He really did. He's got a new interpreter now, though. There's funny photos of the new interpreter online wearing one of those like Mexican wrestling masks.
Really?
Yeah. And he's like the new interpreter for a $700 million guy.
Because I think I read yesterday he was making like $500,000 a year to interpret it for him.
Oh, for what one person. Gig. What a gig.
And then I guess he just had a gambling problem.
Yeah.
Or that allegedly. Yeah, and that's the other thing is like if he was betting on baseball, it'd be a huge...
It problem. Wasn't.
That's what the interpreter's saying, that it wasn't baseball. Because if it's baseball, then...
That's
then
very
that's
messy.
bad for
yes.
Shohei.
But okay.
That'll be a crazy story to follow.
On
to
our almost news. Megan Fox defends drinking MGK's blood. So
gross.
Yeah, well, she's saying it's not that gross, actually. Gross. Let's listen to her on the Call Her Daddy podcast.
How many times did you see, like, little boys would go out with, like, their little pop guns and they would cut their fingers and, like, be blood brothers, right? And they're like, we're best friends forever now. And they would, like, smush the blood together on their fingers.
Uh-huh.
That's not satanic, right? That's normal and that's cute. That's sweet. That's like an innocent, like...
little bond.
Yeah, it's a little bond between kids who love each other. They have a pure friendship. It's like that, except instead of rubbing your fingers together, the drop of blood goes in your mouth.
Wow.
First of all, what she described is like a 90s movie. Kids don't actually do that.
She was actually describing 90s movies.
Yeah, it was literally every 90s like little kid movie.
But that wasn't
like,
based on real life? Did kids used to do that back in
the
day?
I've never shared blood with anyone. You look like a guy who would drink blood. Right. Honestly, you probably are going to side with her on this.
No, I mean, when in Rome, you know?
Exactly.
If I was with Megan Fox and she wanted to drink my blood or vice...
Now you're putting me in a corner.
Yeah. this was an interesting podcast.
Shout out to Alex Cooper, the Color Daddy girl. Like, I mean,
she's
just
getting everyone.
Incredible rise to fame and then just gets every major guest.
To open up, too.
And they'll sit down for hours, talk about, like, everything. Yeah, didn't she get into, like, all of her surgeries? Wouldn't really get into, right, is the MGK relationship. Said they called off the engagement, but didn't really get into like where they're at.
Yeah, that she said something like, I'll always be tied to him no matter what.
Well,
like,
you drink his blood.
Yeah.
Of course you will.
But I don't know if they're still together or not. She was very sort of like coy about that.
And then she talked about like, the only thing I didn't really think was like a headline. She talked about all the surgeries she'd done. Have you seen photos of her?
Yeah, she said she had 3 boob job surgeries, a bunch of other things.
And she's like, oh, there's one that I'm going to keep private.
Yeah.
So was that like the vagina one?
Oh, do you think that's what it is? Oh, true. That why would
you keep... why what you talked about every other one?
Sorry,
I didn't want to get graphic.
Oh, that's all right. Anyway.
I don't know. I was thinking about it last night.
Oh,
no,
Deven.
No, thinking about like which one it was.
Deven.
Well,
just working.
Just working.
Working late.
Working on an angle.
All right, Blood Brothers. Should we do it now?
Don't touch me.
Okay. Thank you for joining me, Deven.
Of course.
And we'll see you guys here tomorrow. Goodbye.